When I was 24 years old, I had just started a career at the New York Post, just graduated from college. Everything was very new and exciting. And then things quickly fell apart. I started behaving in ways that I didn't recognize as myself. I felt out of control. And from there, escalated very quickly, and I started experiencing hallucinations and paranoia. And from there, even devolved even quicker. But I will leave that to the movie to tell the rest of that story, I think. So the disease itself affects the brain in a way that makes memory impossible. So most of that time is lost to me. So I actually had to use kind of skills as a journalist. I'm a journalist by trade. And I had to use those skills to uncover, you know, a lot of that time and relying on other people's recollections. So a lot of those feelings and kind of I couldn't access because they weren't there to begin with. So it was an experience of a journalistic enterprise, really.
So as if you were writing about someone else.
Absolutely, yeah. So I was the 217th person to be diagnosed with what's called anti-NMDA receptor autoimmune encephalitis. And the disease itself was named in 2005 and really, well, was described in 2005 and really named in 2007. And I was treated in 2009. So had that been prior to 2005, I definitely would not be sitting at this table here right now. So I got very, very lucky to, you know, it seemed like a harrowing journey, which it was, but many people out there face far more harrowing journeys than I did, and some of them are actually going to be at the premiere tonight. But it's a kind of testament to the fact that we need really pliable, interested doctors who are also listening and also, you know, reading up on the literature. You know, that's one thing that, well, not only is he an amazing listener and an amazing clinician, but he also is a researcher on top of that. So I really benefited from the kind of, from that and getting to him as swiftly as I did. So there was basically you need a trigger. And in my case, I had enlarged lymph nodes in my spine, which leads many to believe, well included, that I probably had a flu. The flu was probably my trigger. So it can be it could be anything like that, but I had the genetic inclination to make these harmful antibodies that attack the brain.